Welcome to This Day in Baseball. We bring you everything from the thrill of victory to the agony of defeat and every milestone and oddball event in between. Today's game is courtesy of thisdayinbaseball.com. You can come for a peek, make friends for a lifetime. Before, after, and during the game, check out the links below the video and visit the player pages, parks, and teams as you listen to this blast from the past. You can catch us on every social media platform. And I want to do a special thanks to MLB Classic Radio Archives for this broadcast. Now, let's play ball.
We're ready to go. Burdette gets set. Dodgers didn't score in the second. Here's the pitch on the way. It's a strike call. Al Foreman working in first base, Stan Landis in second base, Eddie Sudol in third base. Here's the wind of a pitch to Clyde, bouncing ball to strike, that ought to be easy. Groats got it and fires, one away. Groats throws out Ty Cline, that's one gone. Here's Frank Bolling hitting 247. Made the final out of the ballgame yesterday on a fine play by Kenny Lawyer. Bolling with five homers and 42 RBIs. Hitting 247. The Phillies are batting in the bottom of the second, leading 2-0. Right-handed batter Bolling waits. Here is Burdette getting set. Cardinal infield peppers it up. Here's the windup. The pitch is on the way. And it's a strike call. Hit that outside corner. This is a big day for Lou Burdette. One strike and no balls. He's facing his former teammates, and the best game he's pitched as a member of the Cardinals was against the Braves when he beat Spahn 3-1. Here's the pitch on the way to Bolling. A ground ball. Javier to his left. He's up. He throws. He's out at first base. Two men up, two men down. And Burdette has thrown nothing but strikes. And here's Henry Aaron. Batting 320. The Phillies didn't score in the bottom of the second. The Dodgers now bat in the third. Phillies leading 2-0. Here's Henry Aaron batting 320. We're in the first game of the doubleheader. In the first inning with two out and nobody on. Henry's had 41 homers. He's driving for the triple crown. Home runs, RBIs, and batting championship. He trails in batting by 8 points. As Groot is holding on. Here is Burdette winding. Here's the pitch on its way, and it is a slider than this. Low and outside. One ball, no strike. Two men are out. The ball game in the first inning. The Cardinals play Aaron you know where, and around the left field. Very deep. Skip, who's been doing the games at Atlanta all year long, watching the young Redbirds. Back home, watching the game with us up in the booth today. One ball and no strike. My son hasn't changed a bit. Just gotten about 6 months older. That's a fine. And the pitch is on the way. And it's a fastball a little bit low. Two balls to no strike. That could have been nasty and said only gained about 6 pounds, but I won't say that. Two balls, no strike. Two men out and nobody on. The ball game in the first. They want to see the baseball. Henry Aaron called for it. I wonder why. I tell you, Lou, if he ever threw a spitball, throw it today. Anything to get him out. Two balls, no strike. Two men out, nobody on base. The ballpark is packed. Lou Burdette pitching to Henry Aaron. Now the side. The windup. The pitch on the way. There's a high fly ball. Right field. James coming over. He should get it. He's under the ball. The inning is over. Henry Aaron flies to James and right. 1-2-3 and out for the Braves. The Cardinals now come to bat. No score in this ball game. The gun is bottom of the first, and Javier leads it off. The Dodgers are batting in the third, trailing the Phillies 2-0. Javier hitting 269 will lead it off against Bob Hendley. Hendley has won five. Lost four, but he's always pitched. Great ball against the Cardinals. Javier leading off. Henley, of his five victories this year, three have been over the Cardinals. That's what I mean. This guy something in Burdette. But you gotta beat them all. It don't make any difference whether their name is Hendley, Spine, Ellsworth, Jackson. We beat some pitchers this week. Javier, lead it off. Right-handed batter up there. Bright sun is shining. A lovely day. Only one thing will make them more perfect. A double victory. Here's the pitch on the way. And it swung the ground ball right back to the mound. Hey, he's interfered with. He's interfered. There's a record set. Javier is interfered with for the fourth time this year, which establishes a major league record. It's the fourth time that as he swung, the catcher tipped his bat with his glove. So Javier is credited with interference. That's the fourth time this year. And he's safe at first base. That's a major league record. That's never happened to one man four times in a year. Here now is Dick Groat with a runner at first and nobody out. Groat with six homers and 71 runs batted in, hitting 328. There's a stretch by Bob Hendley. Now the pitch on the way. Here it is. He fouled trying to hit in the right field. Strike one. Javier is on. As he swung and tapped the ball to Hendley, his bat was touched by the catcher, Joe Torres. One strike to nothing. Big groan up there. The ballpark is jammed. The Dodgers are here tomorrow night. It'll be Broglio against Padres. Here's the stretch now to throw to first base the runner back. Gabrielson, who's a left-hand hitter but a right-hand thrower, is playing first base. Big groan up there. Straddles the plate. Now the stretch by Hendley from the belt and the pitch. Here it is. Way high and outside. That evens it up at the ball on the strike. The Dodgers did not score in the third. Silly, 2-0. We'll keep you up with everything. Here's the stretch. Now from the belt. The pitch is on the way. There goes the runner. Throwing side at the ball and missed, and the runner is out. Landed still. The hit and run, but the Braves diagnosed it. Groat threw his bat at the ball, but missed it. The strike two. Javier is out trying to steal. From Torrey, you can really fire that ball to McMillan. There's no doubt the Braves' future plans call for Torrey to catch. He's only 24 years old, and he's going to be a great one. Good hitter. Great arm. Throwing the windup now, the pitch to Groat on the way. There's a hot smash. That would have been a base hit with a runner at first, but now it's an easy out. Gabrielson dropping back, but nobody on to hold on. Fields the ball. Here's Musial. Two out and nobody on. Throwing the left-hand batter up there. Two out, nobody on base. Musial hitting 254. 11 homers and 56 RBIs. Now the pitch by Hendley on the way. He swings and he misses strike one. One strike to no bond. It's amazing about this Hendley. He can't beat anybody else, but he beats us regularly. He scored five victories all season, three against the Cardinals. About time we changed that. One strike to no ball. Here's the windup. The pitch is on the way. It's a curve strike two call. Two strikes and nothing. Come on, you Stan. Come on, you Philly. Joe Torrey was charged with an error on that interference call. Two strikes, no balls. Here's the pitch. Outside slider, barely missed. Two strikes and a ball. We're in the first inning. Musial the hitter. Two men are out. Now the signal. Bob Hendley gets set. Sam crouches. The youngster from Macon, Georgia, whines. Here's the pitch on the way. Fly ball. Popped in the short right center. It's going to be caught. Mike Klein is there. He has it. Musial pops to Klein in short center. No hits, no runs, one error, nobody left. At the end of one inning, no score in the ballgame.
My country's leads the way.
Start saving for a brighter day. With a savings plan that pays, they're the best in money ways.
My country's today.
Evansville temperature is 80 degrees, the time 14 minutes after 1.
And don't get excited when I tell you Philadelphia got 7, because that's the Eagles. The football Eagles got 7 in the first period. Here's Eddie Mathews to lead it off. Hitting 263 with 21 homers and 81 runs batted in. Finals of play. Will Burdette getting set. He retired a 1-2-3 in the first. Now the signal given. Into the windup. Burdette's pitch is on the way. It's a fastball low. One ball, no strike. Eddie Mathews up there. Boyer plays wide of the bag at third. Now Burdette gets set. The windup, and here's the pitch on the way. There's a drive in the right center field. James going back, back, back. One-handed catch on the run. James made a fine running one-handed snap of Eddie Mathews' long line drive. One out, and here's Gene Oliver batting 253. 16 homers and 62 runs batted in. Gene Oliver up there. Right-hand hitter. One out. Nobody on. Burdette has retired 4 men in a row. Well, Boyer, White, and Flood coming up on our second. Philly's batting in the bottom of the third, leading 2-0. Here's Burdette getting ready. Now the pitch on the way to Oliver. It's a strike, a good fastball. One strike and no ball. One out. Burdette rubs up that baseball. The flag is limp atop the pole. There's no wind advantage today. Anything they hit, they earn. One strike and no ball. Right-hand hitter waiting. Gene Oliver. Burdette gets ready. Here's the windup. The pitch is on the way. Just missed the outside corner with a slider. One ball, one strike. One man out. Gene Oliver up there. We're in the second inning. Phillies didn't score in the third, but they lead 2-0 at the end of 3. One ball, one strike. Now the windup, and here's the pitch. Fastball low and away. 2 balls and a strike on Gene Oliver. Joe Torre will be next. Willie Mays homers for the Giants with a man on in the first for Pittsburgh. 2 balls and a strike. Gene Oliver, the batter. The windup and now the pitch. Line smash to Grotto, one hop. He's got it. He throws over to first base in time. That ball was hit hard. A one hop right at the Grotto. And there's two away now. And here's Joe Torre. Right-handed hitter. Ball game in the second inning. No score. Burdette against Hendley. It'll be Sadecki against the Master in the second game. Hope you have plenty of Busch Bavarian beer on hand. It'll be a long and exciting afternoon. Now ready. There's the windup by Burdette. The pitch is on the way. It's a little low. Crossfire fastball that time. Sidearm crossfire, but he got a low. Torre homer yesterday. He's got 14 for the year. He's hitting 287. Travels the plate wide. Holds that bat long. Burdette one end. Here's the pitch on the way. Strike over the outside corner. Lou Burdette threading a needle over the corner of the plate. One ball, one strike. 2 men out. Ball game in the second inning. Burdette gets ready. Now the signal. The windup and a pitch. And here it is. Ground ball to short. Roach got it. There's the peg. Sided, retired. 2 perfect innings pitched by Burdette. Nothing across. We go to the bottom half of the second inning. No score. Carlton got it. If you're hungry for flavor, that's all you have to remember. And it's easy to remember once you enjoy that smooth, rich taste Yes, carrots and carrot. Flavor you never thought you'd get from any filter cigarette. One pack of dual filter carrots. True filter smoking never tasted so good. Fine flavor-rich tobaccos go in the carrot. Then the famous dual filter with activated charcoal brings through the best flavor of these choice tobaccos. So why be hungry for flavor? Carrots and carrot. Flavor you never thought you'd get from any filter cigarette. Pick up a carton of dual filter carrots real soon.
Comes with a man on, and the Cardinals lead 2-0.
Phillies are leading 2-1 in the fourth. Now the signal, into the windup. Here's the pitch to Kurt Flood. He swings and he fouls tip, strike two. Two strikes to nothing. Well, it'll be the Dodgers and the Cardinals here the next three nights. The Redbirds can win two today, won a series to look forward to. Two strikes to nothing. There's a signal given. Into the windup. Here's the pitch on the way. High and inside. Two strikes and a ball on Flood hitting 311 with five homers and 60 runs batted in. Now Hendley gets set. Flood waits. Here's the pitch on the way. Tap right back to the mound. He fooled him. Over to first base, easy out. Flood taps back to Hendley. So that's one out. And here is Charlie James hitting 270 with nine homers and 39 runs batted in. Charlie's going to be playing a lot. There's a left-hander in this game, another one in the second game, LeMaster, Padres tomorrow night, Kopac Tuesday night, and Rickard Wednesday night. Now the windup and here's the pitch. James takes a curve strike call. One strike to no ball. The Dodgers have scored at least one in the fourth. Tommy Davis homer. One strike to no ball. Here's the pitch on the way. Strike two, a good fastball. At the same time that Kenny Boyer scored ahead of Bill White's homer, the pitcher brings in Tommy Davis hitting a homer with a bases empty. Strike to nothing. Charlie James batting 270. Right hand hitter up there. Now the signal. Ready. The pitch is on the way. He struck him out. James goes down swinging. Well, that's two out. And here's McCarver batting 294. The president of his fan club, Will Carruthers, of the Memphis Press Scimitar, watching him here. Getting a nice hand. 2-0 in favor of the Cardinals. There's the line. Now the pitch. Here it is. Curve strike at the knees draw. That's all the Dodgers got, was one and a fourth on Davis's homer. Philly's now batting. Come on, get some runs over there. Now the windup. Here's the pitch on the way to McCarver. He swings and he misses. Strike two. This Henley is tough out there. White tried to bunt on the first pitch, you know. Then hit one on the roof. Two strikes or nothing. Left hand bat away. Now the wind, and here's the pitch. A high pop foul out of play off to the left. Boy, this ticker drives you crazy today. Football scores, Dodgers score. Two strikes and no ball. For a guy with only one contact lens on, I'm going nuts up here. Two strikes and nothing. There's the windup, and the pitch is on the way. He struck him out. Not a good inning. Two hits, two runs. No errors and nobody left. And at the end of two, it's the Cardinals 2, Milwaukee, nothing.
Hungry for flavor, Jerry shoots out in flavor.
Now leaves you hungry for flavor. Try dual filter tires. you're in for a pleasant surprise. Here's flavor you never thought you'd get with any filter cigarette. Fine, flavor-rich tobaccos go into Paris. Then the famous dual filter brings through the best flavor of these choice tobaccos. So why put it off any longer? Get acquainted with that Tarotin flavor today. Pick up a carton of dual filter Tarotin. Philly starting in the bottom of the fourth, leading 2-1 over the Dodgers. Lou Burdette ready to pitch the third for the Cardinals with the Redbirds out in front, 2-0. They hear from all over today. Identification, it's the Cardinals baseball network.
Your sports station, WGBS, 1280 on your dial, Evansville.
This is Harry Carey with Joey Groves here at Busch Stadium. We're ready to go into the bottom half of the third inning, and here's Len Gabelson. Got us into a jam with a pinch double yesterday. Here's a pitch on the way. He takes the screwball strike call over the outside corner, and he hides. One strike and no ball. All game in the top of the third. 2-0 in favor of the Cardinals, shooting fourth or ninth in a row. Now the windup by Burdette. The pitch is on the way. Swung and he's hot fouled out of play. Boy, I wish that Philadelphia Eagle football score would stop coming in. Every time I look around, I see Philadelphia 7. Maybe those Phillies will accommodate me and come up with their own 7. It's a natural number. Two strikes and no ball. Here's the windup and the pitch on the way. Screwball going outside. Len Gabelson with 3 homers and 12 runs batted in. Summer at Denver. Now Burdette gets ready. Here's the pitch. Low outside. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Gabelson, a big left-handed batter, went to school at the University of Southern California. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Now the signal. Left-hand hit away. Into the wind up the pitch, and here it is. He struck him out on his 2-ball. Gabrielson goes down swinging, that 7 men in a row. Phillies did not score in the fourth. 2-1 Philadelphia at the end of four. Dallas Green for the Phillies. Drysdale for the Dodgers. Here's McMillan, the shortstop. 1 out and nobody on the ball game in the third. Harry Renfro with the women in his life. His wife and daughter, of course. She says it better be. Now the pitch. High fly ball, right field. James is there. Don't worry about this one. Easy out. He's got it. Left-handed, he bats right-handed. Real baby-faced looking youngster, just 24. Beaten the Cardinals 7 times in his lifetime, which in the major leagues is very short. Here's the pitch on the way. He takes a strike call. Hendley, as a batter, has 5 hits, so he's no patsy. One strike to no ball. 2 out and nobody on. Top of the third. 2-0 Cardinals. Here's the pitch on the way. Pass ball a little bit low. And that evens it up for a ball and a strike. Bob Hendley up there. Lou Burdette hasn't allowed a base runner yet. Lou winds, a 1-1 pitch on the way. He swings and misses strike two. Two strikes and a ball. Two men out, nobody on, we're in the third. Lou, Burdette gets set. The pitch to Bob Hendley is on the way.
It's a honey of a sale, now in progress, Sears' 77th anniversary sale. Follow the swarms of smart shoppers. Go to Sears for this honey of a sale. Get your choice of a wide assortment of hand tools and hardware items at Sears only 77 cents each. These are timely items you need now to fix up and paint up around your home. Save $1.45 a gallon on Sears' famous Master Mix House Paint. Regularly $5.89 a gallon, now only $4.44 during Sears' 77th anniversary sale. 10-quart capacity plastic pails, regularly 89 cents, only 25 cents. All these items featured in Sears' basement downtown or in North Park during Sears' 77th anniversary sale, now in progress. Sears Downtown, 4th and Sycamore, open Monday, Wednesday, and Friday till 8:30. And Sears North Park, open nightly till 9.
Tonight, Sam from the crowd. He has retired 9 men in a row. Every man he gets out with the Cardinals leading 2-0 brings him just that much closer to a victory. Burdette up there. Not a bad hitting pitcher, by the way. Bob Hendley gets set. Bill White Homer with a man on as the ballgame so far. 2-0 Cardinals. Now Hendley gets ready. Into the wind, and the pitch is on the left. It's a strike at the knees call. One strike and no ball. Lubert on right-handed batter, right-handed pitcher. Out of signal given. Here's the pitch. He swings and he misses strike two. Two strikes and nothing. About 30,000 fans on hand. Bleachers are packed. Pavilion is crowded. Two strikes and nothing on Burdette. Here's the pitch. He tapped it. Foul ball. Joe Torre tried to grab it while it was fair. Couldn't get to it. Two strikes and nothing. Right hand hitter up there. Lubert up trying to get something started. Here's the winder by Hendley. And here's the fifth. Does can give you that slow in the dugout sit down as long as you possibly can routine that most pitchers do to conserve their strength. One out. Here's Javier. And now, Tom Gorman wants to look at the baseball. It's all right. One out. Nobody gone. Ball game in the third. Javier, who is safe on interference, first inning. Pitch. He swings and he fouls it back for a strike. One strike and over. There are still reserved seats for tomorrow night's game, the entire Dodger series, by the way. So don't stay away thinking it's going to be sold out, because it isn't. One strike and no ball. Right hand hitter, Javier. Now the windup by Hendley. Here's the pitch. Strike two call. Two strikes and nothing. One out. Bottom of the third. Cardinals are leading 2-0. The Braves will have the top of the batting order starting the fourth. Two strikes, no balls. Now ready. Into the windup. Here's the pitch. He struck him out. Javier goes down swinging. Boy, other than Boyer's double and White's home run, we haven't done a thing with young Hendley. Those are the only two hits we have, and we lead 2-0. Here's Dick Gross. Musial would be next. Ball game in the third. 2-0 Cardinals. Dodgers batting in the fifth and trailing 2-1. Now Henley takes a look around. There's the windup. The pitch on the way. There's a little pop fly on the infield. Bolling going out. Aaron comes in, and Aaron makes the catch in short right field. So Groot pops out. 1-2-3, nothing across. At the end of three innings, the Cardinals 2, the Braves nothing.
Dan Musial of the St. Louis Cardinals has become an inspiration and an idol for little leaguers, pony leaguers, and boys everywhere. When Stan plays his last scheduled baseball game on Sunday, September 29th, one boy from the tri-state area and his dad or a friend will be the guests of Morris Plan Thrift and Green and Green in box seats at Busch Stadium. A pair of box seat tickets for Stan Musial Day and $25 expense money will be given to the boy 14 years old or under who comes up with the best reason for wanting to attend Stan Musial Day. Simply tell us in 25 words or less why you want to attend Stan Musial Day. Write your entry on a postcard and mail it to Cardinals, WGBF, Post Office Box 485, Evansville. That's Cardinals, WGBF, Post Office Box 485, Evansville, Indiana. All entries must be postmarked no later than midnight, Friday, September 20th. The winner of a pair of box seats and $25 for a trip to St. Louis on Stan Musial Day will be announced on the Cardinal broadcast Tuesday night, September 24th.
Pat Klein will lead it off here. He bounced out in the first inning. He's batting 220. No homers and 9 RBI. A left-handed batter with good speed. Here's Burdette, who hasn't allowed a base runner yet. An old campaigner. Will he rise to the occasion of this important ball game? So far, he has indicated that he has. The best he's looked since he joined the Cardinals. Here's the pitch to Ty Klein now. A ground ball, the deep shot. Throw can't reach it, a base hit. There's the first base runner as Klein bounced one past Groat in the left field. Groat had him played a little bit to pull and was over near second base. Normally that ball would be an easy out. Here now is Bolling. He bounced out to Javier on the first. Right hand hitter up there. Likes to poke that ball in the opposite field. Likes to hit the run. Ty Klein very fast at first base. Henry Aaron is next. the pitch. Strike over the outside corner call. One strike and no ball. Twine, the runner on. Nobody out, we're in the fourth. 2-0 in favor of the Cardinals. White's home run with a man on. Boyer doubled to start the second and White homer. One strike, no ball. Now ready. Lou Burdette takes a look around. There's the stretch and the hesitation. The pitch. Line drive foul into the right field corner. He's way ahead of him now. Two strikes and nothing. Coming through on the ticker, it's hard to tell whether anything's happening in an inning or not. In other words, the posting of a score might be delayed because the football material is being sent through. Two strikes and nothing. Dodgers did not score in the fifth. Two to one, the Cardinals. The Phillies lead the Dodgers. Here's a pitch. Well outside. 2-0, the Cardinals lead the Braves. Two strikes and a ball. Just close to zero. A lot of transistors here today. You can tell as we mentioned the score before they put it on the board. Now ready. Two strikes and a ball. Lou Burdette gets set. A lead by Ty Klein. The pitch to Bolling. A hot smash to Javier. Looks like a double play. Second base one. First base two.
He's got room. He's under the ball. He's got it.
hits, no runs, no errors, nobody left. In four innings, Burdette has faced only 12 men, which is perfection. He allowed one hit that was erased in the double play. We go to the bottom of the fourth. The Cardinals 2, Milwaukee nothing.
And it's a honey of a sale. Sears is offering exciting values in every department during this 77th anniversary sale. Follow the swarms of smart shoppers to Sears and save over $15 on silk and worsted imported men's suits. Regularly priced at $65, now only $49.80 during the 77th anniversary sale. Choose your suit value from gray, black, blue, and brown in regular, short, and long styles. Styles full shirts, 3 for $10, saving of $1.94. Men's casual slacks, regularly $4.98, now only $2.88. These slacks are of combed cotton in year-round weight. These bargains are featured on the main floor near downtown at 4th and Sycamore, open Monday, Wednesday, and Friday till 8:30, and Sears North Park open nightly till 9.
Now on the bottom of the fourth, here's Sam Musial will lead it off. Wide out on the first inning. Hendley starting in the bottom of the fifth, leads the Dodgers 2-1. Cardinals here lead the Braves 2-0. Here's Musial. Now Hendley leans forward, gets set. The wind up and out of pitch on the way.
Now only $2.88. These slacks are of combed cotton in year-round weight. These bargains are featured on the main floor near downtown at 4th and Sycamore, open Monday, Wednesday, and Friday till 8:30, and Sears North Park open nightly till 9.
Hello to the bottom of the fourth. Here's Sam Musial will lead it off. Wide out on the first inning. Thank you.
the bottom of the fifth, leading 2-1. Now the wind, here's the pitch. It's a strike over the outside corner of fastball. One strike to no ball. One out and nobody on. Kenny Boyer up there. Bob Hendley, who's allowed only two hits. One strike, no ball. The pitch on the way. Way outside, a let up. That evens it up at a ball and a strike. One out, nobody on. Fourth inning. Hendley gets that. Boyer waits. Here's the windup and out of fifth. Below. Boyer, watch.
Like a tremendous pitcher.
And three of the five he's won have been against. Take that back, he's 1-9 in Las Vegas.
That's his record. Three of the nine he's won
have been over the Cardinals. Burdette's record, 8-11. Two balls and a strike. Here's the pitch by Hendley. There's a high fly ball. Deep left field. Way back. It might be out of here. Here.
Claude Raymond, the right-hander, is down there, and Dan Schneider, the left-hander. I think that one Raymond who just started to warm up, he has another. Now Schneider coming in. I don't think Raymond can make it because he just started to throw. So Dan Schneider, a left-hander, and you can tell what the opposition thinks about the Cardinals. They want to throw left-handers against them in every situation. Southpaw pitching. For example, the Dodgers are going to pitch three left-handers in a row. At the end of five innings in Philadelphia, the Phillies two, the Dodgers one. Let's pause for identification. This is the Cardinals Baseball Network.
Your sports station, WGBS 1280 on your dial, Evansville.
Harry Carey with Jerry Gross here at beautiful Busch Stadium. Capacity crowd on hand. The Cardinals are leading 3-0. And Dan Schneider, who was knocked out in the playoffs by the Atlanta Farm Club of the Cardinals in a 10-run inning, comes into relief. The runner at first base, Bill White, edges away. Here's the stretch. And Schneider pitched to Kirk Blood. Ball one. I hear from Huntingburg, Indiana today. One of my favorite towns. Also from Fairfield, Iowa. Now the signal. There's the stretch. The pitch on the way. One way trying to hit the right field and fouled it off. One ball, one strike. Representative from Joe Adcock, hotel down in Natchez, Mississippi here today. Good friend of ours, Joe, now with the Cleveland Indians. One ball, one strike. Don't have Adcock in the lineup today. He's a murderer. Here's the stretch. 1-1 pitch. He missed the changeup. Strike two. The Dodgers did not score in the sixth. So they only three more innings left for them up there. The Phillies are now batting at the bottom of the sixth. Can beat those guys. Anything can happen. Here's the stretch. And the pitch on the way to Flood. A bouncing ball. Shortstop in. Wait a second. He's out. He'd had a tough time getting Flood at first base. But he had the short play in front of him and flipped over to Bolling and just barely got white. Here's Charlie James now with two outs. One run in, a runner at first. Batting 270, fan, his first time up against Hendley, now facing Danny Schneider, a 20-year-old youngster from Phoenix, Arizona, got a big bonus to sign with the Braves. Here's the strike, and the pitch, James takes it high. One ball and no strike, now the signal given, into the stretch, from the belt. Here's a pitch. High outside. Two balls and nothing. Charlie James, the hitter. Dan Schneider gets set. Into the stretch he goes. The pitch to James. Ball three. McCarver with the next. Three balls, no strikes. We're here from DuPoint, Illinois, from Dyersburg, Tennessee. From Germantown, Illinois. the pitch. James takes a strike. My favorite town, this one's got to be from Otter Creek, Illinois.
Joe Torre out on deck. Mathews in this series has gone 0 for 9. Oliver has a base hit in 7 trips in this series against his former mate. Gene hit the ball well his first time up, but lined it on the ground to Dick Grote at short. One out, we're in the fifth inning. Redbirds leading by the score of 3-0. Lou Burdette out on the mound. And the pitch to Oliver is the fastball that's in there around the knees for a strike. Klein has the only base hit. He bounced a single through the infield in the fourth inning. But he was erased on a double play and a fine play by Grote as Klein was down his throat in the middleman situation as Javier threw to Dick. The pitch is a breaking ball line foul down the left field line and right into the Redbird bullpen. No balls and two strikes, one down. We're in the fifth. Oliver broke his bat. The Redbirds looking to win their 18th in the last 19 games. The Cardinals now have an 8-game winning streak on the line. And also in this doubleheader, the Redbirds have won 14 straight at home. Oliver is ready, has a new bat. The outfield plays him deep. Kurt Flood way around in left center. And very deep in left field is Musial. And now Oliver asks for the ball and played up by Tom Gorman, gets it from Burdette and back it goes. Sun shining down now. At the onset, it was not shining behind a cloud. No wind to speak of. The strike two pitch, and Oliver hits it up into the air off the right field line. Bill White goes back, and it's foul territory. Makes the catch.
And now lead 4-1. And listen to the crowd roar that Philadelphia Phillies 2 runs goes up in the sixth. And if you don't think a few of the Redbirds are taking a peek at that scoreboard, you have another thing coming. The Phillies lead 4-1 at the end of sixth. The Redbirds here lead by 3-0, with 2 down at the top of the fifth.
Joe Torre is on the corner as Burdette gets ahead, and he's been right around that plate.
I don't know about everybody else, but I'm going to have a cold Bush Pavilion drink to the Phillies on that one.
And light up a dual filter diet and cigarette. And settle back and enjoy baseball here at Bush Stadium throughout the afternoon. Lou Burdette rocks into the motion. The one strike pitch. He is in there. Strike two call. 36-year-old veteran Burdette trying to beat his former mate and push the Cardinals closer toward the pennant. Burdette will give you the slider, the screwball, throws the sinker. Johnny Gene saying before the game that his bullpen is well rested. He has Chance and Barney Schultz. Lots of rest available. Just to name a few. Ron Taylor conceivably could come back in a very short relief situation. 2 down in the fifth. 3-0 Cardinals. Joe Torre today bounced it short on his first trip. The strike two pitch, sidearm curve, strike three call. Got it on the outside corner. And that is Burdette's third strikeout. And he sets them down in order in the fifth. No runs, no hits, no errors, no one left on. And at the end of 4.5, the Cardinals still lead 3-0.
The Los Angeles Dodgers will be here Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday night.
How can you tell a real fan out here at the ballpark? Might give you one way. He's the guy that managed a scorecard, a pencil, a hot dog, a bottle of beer, and a cigarette all at one time.
Still tickets available.
And how can you tell he's really enjoying that cigarette? Well, that's easy, too. Just look for the white ring that identifies every dual filter carousel.
then you just know he's getting flavor and plenty of it. Flavor you never thought you'd get from any filter cigarette. Fine flavor-rich tobaccos go into town. Then the famous dual filter with activated charcoal actually brings through the best flavor of these choice tobaccos. So why put up with a cigarette that leaves you hungry for flavor? Harrison's got it. Flavor you never thought you'd get from any filter cigarette. Get yourself a carton of dual filter Harrison today. As for the Cardinals, as we go to the last of the fifth, it'll be Lou Burdette to lead it off, followed by the top of the order, Julian Javier, and then, of course, Dick Gross. Other scores, that Chicago-Washington game, the American League postponed rain. New York at Minnesota, Boston at Kansas City. Later on, Baltimore at Detroit, 0-0 at the end of 2.5. Pappas against Larry, and it'll be Cleveland at L.A. in the American League later on this afternoon. Houston, New York, 1-2 in the National. 2-0, the Colt 45s over the Mets. Farrell against Jackson at the end of 4. L.A. and Philadelphia, 4-1. At the end of 6, the Phillies leading the Dodgers. Drysdale against Dallas Green. One home run in the game, Tommy Davis, is 14th in the 4th. Green and Drysdale still in there. The left-hander Schneider's first pitch is a fastball that's in there for a strike. And Burdette, who bounced to 3rd, is up for his 2nd time this afternoon and leading by 3. The Giants lead the Pirates 3-1 at the end of 4. Schneider's pitch is nubbed out in front of the plate on the ground, and it goes foul off to the right. That's a battle at San Francisco-Milwaukee situation. Both clubs are 11 games behind in the battle for 3rd place. So the Braves are out to win this one. Trying to clinch 3rd spot, and they had a shot at 2nd place, too. 2 strikes now to Lou Burdette. Schneider's pitch, fastball hit out to left center. Moving over from left field is Oliver. He's under the ball. Klein there. They almost collide, but Klein makes the catch. One up, one down in the 5th. That'll bring Julian Javier to the top of the batting order with one out here in the 5th. So the Dodgers now batting in the 7th inning. 9 outs to get for Dallas Green. Evansville, Indiana, left-hander, 20-year-old, big kid, he's 6'3", Snyder out in relief of Bob Hendley, gave up all 3 runs, 3 1/3 plus 2 men, accidentally swings and hits it down the first baseline, it's a fair ball, Gabrielson is up and runs to the bag in time for the 2nd out, so on a check swing, Javier tried to hold up, and the ball went off the inside portion of his bat, down the line, and Gabrielson just didn't make the play. That almost went for extra bases. 2 up and 2 down here in the 5th. That'll bring Dick Gross to the plate. Dick has bounced to the first baseman and skied to right. The Dodgers failed to score in the 7th inning. And it goes up on the board. The pitch to Dick Grote is a fastball that's outside. So at the end of 6.5, Philadelphia 4, Los Angeles 1. Hang in there, you Phillies. Schneider is ready. The 1-0 pitch to Dick Grote. Swung on line out toward right field. On comes the right fielder, Hank Aaron, and Henry makes the catch for the 3rd out in the 5th. No runs, no hits, no errors. No one left out. At the end of 5, Cardinals 3, Braves nothing.
Hungry for flavor, it's carries and salad. Flavor, you never thought you'd get
filter cigarette. It's all yours in dual filter Harrison. While we go middle of the sixth inning, the Cardinals are out in front 3-0, and at Philadelphia, the Phillies are batting in the bottom of the seventh, leading 4-1. Just talking with Bob Ray, the sports editor of the Post Dispatch, and we're reminiscing how pitchers like Dallas Green down through the years have thrown a monkey wrench into the works. We remember fellas like Bob Chipman, who all the Cardinals had to do was beat him in 49, and they'd have won a pennant. Chipman would throw that slow stuff up there, and our guys would tie themselves in the knot and pop up. Fellas like Chipman and Jocko Thompson and the nondescript pitcher is the guy that sometimes really derails you when you think you're headed for a pennant. All right, here's Gabrielson. We're in the sixth inning. The score is 3-0. Will Burdette gets set. Into the windup he goes. The pitch is on the way. Gabrielson takes the throw and inside. One ball and no strike. Nobody on and nobody out. The ball game's in the sixth.
Not in the lineup.
been out for quite a while. And I think it should be mentioned, too, that Johnny Keene, one of the reasons he went to Taylor yesterday, he knew that they had no more left-handed batters on their bench, knowing that Lee May was hurt. And Taylor did a tremendous job. One out, we're in the sixth. Burdette responding to the challenge with his best performance so far as the Cardinals. Pop foul. Will it stay in play? Boyer chasing it over near the stands. He might have a chance. can't reach him. Nice try, but he couldn't get to it. Two balls, two strikes.
Hungry for flavor, Jerry just got it. Flavor, flavor, flavor. Who's going to get it?
Javier's back there. Takes it. Mathews pops to Javier. That's one out. Here's Gene Oliver. Dallas Green with a season's record of 5-4. Has a lead over the Dodgers of 6-1 in the eighth. Burdette has allowed only four hits. Two of them were on the infield. But Aaron's home run would have gone out of any ballpark in the world. Boy, did he ever kiss that one. That's the way some golfers hit the golf ball. So pitches on the way. A hot shot, a one hop to Javier. He's got it. Over the first base in time. That's two outs. And here's Joe Torre, the catcher. The Cardinals in their seventh will have Flood, James, and McCarver. Barney Schultz, a knuckleball right-hander, and Bobby Shantz, the little left-hander, down in the bullpen. There's two outs, two runs are in on Aaron's tremendous poke. Joe Torre digging in. There's a pitch smashed into left, the base hit. Torre singles to left. Here's Gabrielson now. Left-handed batter. He represents the leading run at the plate. The tying runs at first. Gambleson single to right in the sixth. Fanned in the third. Shortstop Woody Woodward will be next. Here's the stretch. Now the pitch. There's a high fly ball to short left field. Cole should get it. He's under the ball. The inning is over. Gambleson flies to Cole. With three hits in the inning, two runs, no errors, one left. We go to the bottom of the seventh. The Cardinals 3, Milwaukee 2.
It's a honey of a sale, now in progress, Sears' 77th anniversary sale. Follow the swarms of smart shoppers. Go to Sears for this honey of a sale. Get your choice of a wide assortment of hand tools and hardware items at Sears only 77 cents each. These are timely items you need now to fix up and paint up around your home. Save $1.45 a gallon on Sears' famous Master Mix House Paint. Regularly $5.89 a gallon, now only $4.44 during Sears' 77th anniversary sale. 10-quart capacity plastic pails, regularly 89 cents, are only 25 cents. All these items featured in Sears' basement downtown or in North Park during Sears' 77th anniversary sale, now in progress. Sears downtown, 4th and Sycamore, open Monday, Wednesday, and Friday till 8:30, and Sears North Park, open nightly till 9.
For the lucky seventh now, we could hit some runs. The Cardinals lead by only a tally. 3-2. Henry Aaron's 42nd home run. Put the Braves into the ballgame. Here's Kurt Flood hitless so far. Nothing out of two, facing Bob Shaw. Into the windup, the pitch. There's a line drive. Bolling, and he is out at first. Holy cow, what a play. Bolling raced to his left, made a one-handed stab on the first hop, and threw out Kurt Flood. A dazzler that time. What up. Chicago Bears lead the Green Bay Packers 10-3 in the third quarter. Here's Charlie James, one out and nobody on. Here's the windup, the pitch. Line drive, fair ball, into the corner, extra bases. Charlie's around first. He's headed for second with a double. James
game double into the left field corner. Batting in the ninth inning, trailing 6-1. McCarver is hitless so far, nothing out of two. They're going to walk him intentionally to get to Burdette. McCarver being intentionally bad. Now let's see what the Cardinals are going to do. Burdette is going to hit for himself.
Valley White urge you to be proud that you live in Evansville, Indiana,
the city that is fast gaining the reputation of being dynamic and on the move toward future growth. 560,426 people comprise the Evansville trading area. Over a half million people look to Evansville as a source of supply. Ours is an area rich in agriculture, mining, and oil. To the tri-state area of southern Indiana, southern Illinois, and western Kentucky, the commercial capital is Evansville. Annual business of over a half million dollars is done by the city's retail, wholesale, and service organizations. The folks at Valley White urge you to be proud that you live in Evansville, the city that is meeting the needs of its people, its industry, and commerce in this rapidly changing age.
Well, we go into the eighth, and it's up to Burdette to hold them now. Bob Taylor, the Metropolis, Illinois, is going to be the pinch hitter here.
Number 29, Taylor.
He's about the woodwork.
Bob Taylor,
a right-handed hitter. The lead is cut down to one run. Activity in the bullpen. Another Taylor's up now. Ron Taylor. This Taylor, Bob, Hawk, they call him. No relation of Ben Kerner's. Family of basketball players, but this boy's name is, nickname is Hawk. He got 2 out of 24. .083. Batting average. Burdette getting ready. A windup and out of pitch. He swings and he taps it foul. One strike and no ball. Two gal wires in and wants us, her husband's having a birthday, and she wants us to have Musial between games. Call him long distance to wish him a happy birthday. Here's the pitch swung and foul back.
Lee Ty, she's nice enough to say, call collect.
Oh, me. Two strikes and no ball. Hawk Taylor up there, right-handed batter. Now the signal given. The windup. Here's the pitch by Burdette. He struck him out on three pitches. Another pitch hitter coming out, Don Dillard.
Catcher, number 42, Dillard.
Dillard, a left-handed batter, used to be with the Cleveland Indians.
Dillard.
Hitting .221 for the year. One homer, 12 runs batted in. Bobby Shantz and Ron Taylor are down in the bullpen. The Dodgers already were beaten. 6-1. It'll be Sadecki against LeMaster in the second game. Now the signal given. Ready. The dead line. The pitch is on the way. It's a fastball wide at the knees. The Dodgers open a three-game series here tomorrow night. And there are reserve seats available. So don't be frightened into thinking there's a sellout. There is no sellout. There are seats available. Reserve seats, box seats, too. One ball, no strike. Here's the pitch to Dillard. Strike call. See our good friend Mike Walden sitting down in the Braves box. Mike used to be over in Champaign, Urbana. One ball, one strike. Now works on the Braves telecast. The 1-1 pitch. Swings and he misses. A slowed up screwball. And it's two strikes and a ball. Ty Klein would be next. One out, nobody on. We're in the eighth. 3-2 in favor of the Cardinals. The Dodgers already lost. 6-1. So the Phillies wound up breaking even with them in four games. Two strikes and a ball. Gary Combs in left, Kurt Flood in center, James in right. Lou Burdette getting ready, two strikes and the ball to Don Dillard. Dillard hits out of a wide straddle, left-handed batter, choked up about an inch from the end. Now the signal.
The windup. Here's the pitch on the way. Fly ball to left. That should be caught. Cobb is waiting. And he has it. Gary Cobb took care of Dillard's fly ball. Now Ty Klein comes up. Game too. Cardinals lead by only one. One swing change can change that. Here's a pitch on the way. High pop foul. That could be caught. Boyer over near the railing. He's got it. The inning is over. Klein fouled to Boyer. Nothing across. We go down to the bottom of the eighth. Cardinals 3, Braves 2. Once again, Bill Filter's Parrot that presents another in our series, Know Your Cardinal. Here's something on Ken Boyer. While we're at it, why don't you enjoy a Parrot? Flavor you never thought you'd get from any filter cigarette. Ken Boyer is considered by most to be the best third baseman in the major league. The choice of players, writers, and fans alike. Since his discharge from service in 1953, Boyer has kept tongues wagging with his great defensive play at the hot corner. 5 times he's been selected a member of the National League All-Star. And he's no slouch to the plate either. He's averaged over 20 homers per season in his 9 years as a major leaguer. His 98 RBIs last season equaled his career high as a Cardinal, and already this year he has driven in 107. His brother Cletus Boyer plays third for the Yankees. That's one of the reasons everybody would like to see a Cardinal-Yankee World Series. That would be something to see two rival third baseman brothers playing against each other. Kenny is a father of 4 lovely children. Has one of the most beautiful wives in baseball. We'll be back soon with another in our Know Your Cardinal series. Meantime, remember, if you're hungry for flavor, Carrington's got it. Flavor you never thought you'd get from any filter cigarette. Leads it off. He swings at the first pitch and he misses. Tiefenauer is the new pitcher. Bobby Tiefenauer becomes the 4th pitcher. Gary Kolb up there, the pitch. The knuckleball is outside. Tiefenauer up for a major league trial for the umpteenth time. It's 1-1, lost one for the Braves with a good earned run average of 104. 1.04. Here's a pitch foul. Two strikes and a ball. Bobby Tiefenauer. Facing Gary Cole. Boyer will be next. Looking ahead to the ninth, the Braves have Bolling, Henry Aaron, and Mathews. Two strikes and a ball. Here's the pitch. Way outside. Now, Tiefenauer started the season at Atlanta. The Packers traded him to Toronto for Sam Jones. Sam Jones is now a member of the Cardinals and Tiefenauer a member of the Braves. 2-2 pitch. Cole strikes out on a knuckleball. And that'll bring a Boyer. One out, the bottom of the eighth. Boyer's got a double and a homer. As far as for identification, this is the Cardinals Baseball Network.
This is your sports station in Evansville, WGBF 1280 on your radio dial. Present temperature 80 degrees. Time 2 minutes past 3 o'clock.
This is Harry Carey with Jerry Gross. Here's a pitch to Kenny Boyer, a knuckleball outside, ball one. One ball, no strike. Cardinals are leading. We're in the bottom of the eighth. All the runs today have been scored on homers. Here's a pitch. He hits it down the first baseline, foul. Hit it off the end of the bat. That evens it up with a ball and a strike.
For the Cardinals, Boyer doubled in the second, and White followed with a home run. And the Cardinals went 2-0. Then Boyer homered in the fourth to make it 3-0. Then after Bolling got an infield hit in the seventh, Aaron homered to make it 3-2, and that's where it is now. 1-1 pitch, outside knuckleball. Two balls and a strike. One out, nobody on. Bill White will be next. Bobby Tiefenauer getting ready. And here's the pitch on the way. Swings at a knuckleball and misses. Watching a pitcher like Tiefenauer or Schultz reminds you of the old bottle cap game we used to play. You float the bottle cap up, hit it with a broomstick. Two balls, two strikes. Struck him out. Tiefenauer also strikes out Boyer. Here's Bill White. Cardinals have had only six hits. Here's Bill White up there now. Two out and nobody on. Kurt Flood would be next. White's had a home run and a single. Two out of three. Tiefenauer getting ready. The pitch. Knuckleball strike called. Dick Groot in this series, 1 out of 12. Here's the pitch. Inside and high. One ball, one strike. Two men are out. We're in the eighth. 3-2 in favor of the Cardinals. Now the pitch on the way. Line drive foul outside first. And that evens it up with two balls and two strikes. The Mets are shutting out, or rather the Colts are shutting out the Mets again. 5-0 in the seventh. Now the windup, the 2-2 pitch. A ground ball to the right of Mathews, and they hit. Here's White around first. He's heading for second. He's got a chance. Here's the throw. It's going to be close. He is safe. White doubled down the third base line. And here's Flood with a chance to drive in a run. That gives White 3 out of 4 today. He's had a single, a double, and a homer. But here's Kurt Flood. Kurt's always had pretty good success with knuckleball pitchers because he doesn't swing hard. He just tries to meet the ball. There's the stretch and the pitch. He takes the strike over the inside corner call. One strike to no ball. What a big run that would be to pick up. Now the stretch by Tiefenauer. The pitch. Strike two call. Ball over the inside corner. Both times, Flood came up on the pitches thinking they were inside. And they broke over the corner. Two strikes to nothing. Joe Torre behind the plate, doing a good job catching the knuckleball. White a lead. There's the stretch. The pitch on the way. A ground ball. This inning's going to be over. Bowling's got it. Over to first base.
Flavor, you get the flavor of any milk and cigarette.
Mr. Carrington. Here's Bolling to start the ninth first pitch of strike. Henry Aaron is next. One strike and a ball. Bolling, a right-handed batter, has got one out of three. He got the infield hit in the seventh. It preceded a home run by Aaron. There's a bouncing foul off to the left. Two strikes, no ball. If Flood had just stopped on his way to second base, we'd have picked up the run. White was headed for the plate. But before he could score, Flood had been tagged out at second base. White had stopped, too, thinking the inning was over. A real good call by the first base umpire, Al Foreman, because Gabrielson came off the bag, even though it looked like a routine easy out. He came off the bag, and Flood was called safe. Here's a pitch to Bolling. High pop fly. Short. Right field. White backing up under the ball. He's going to get it. One out. Bolling popped away. But look who's coming up now.
Well, the only thing you can be happy about now, Harry, is the fact that Aaron comes up with no one on instead of Bolling on first.
And here's Henry Aaron, who has had 42 homers. He had a homer in the seventh with a man on. And needless to say, there's a tenseness over this crowd. Lou Burdette gets ready. Here's the pitch. Slider outside, ball one. Can't walk him either because Mathews is next. One ball, no strike. Henry Aaron, big again. What a hitter this fellow is. Boy, you're guarding the line at third against the extra base hit. White guarding the first base line. The outfield is practically out of the park. Here's a pitch. There's a high pull. Redbirds will move within a game and a half if they can get this guy out.
One ball, one strike. And as Burdette dribbles around, Mathews Burns steps out of the batter's box. As Nero fiddles, Mathews Burns. One ball, one strike. Don't get him too mad, Lou. Here's the pitch on the way. Line drive, it is a fair ball into the corner and extra base hit. Mathews around first on his way to second. Gene Oliver will be the batter. Mathews line to double to left. So here's Gene Oliver coming up with a tying run at second base, two out. Hit the ball hard twice, foul out the other time. Nothing out of three. Once he hit a one-hopper to Gross. Another time he hit a wicked one-hopper to Javier. Right hand batter waiting. And Burdette wants a new baseball. Two men are out in the ninth. Cardinals are leading 3-2. Burdette rubs up that baseball. Gene Oliver digging in. Eddie Mathews, the runner at second base. Here's the stretch. Now the pitch. Strike call! One strike and no ball. Now facing the right-hand batter. After Mathews doubled into the left field corner. There are two men out. Squeezes the rouser side. He gets set. Signal given. There's the stretch. The pitch on the way. There's a high fly ball. Deep center field. Front back. Back. He's there.
Dodgers by only two games in the all-important loss column.
And that, of course, looks bigger and bigger as you get down to the wire. The big hits, of course, Boyer with an RBI in the fourth inning, his home run accounting for the winning margin. And my, how that young man has come along. Not only with great defensive play, Harry, but in this winning streak, which he more or less started, and you pointed it out the other day in Philadelphia some 19 games ago, Boyer has hit 7 home runs, or 6 home runs, I believe, in that span. He has been brilliant in the field when necessary, and he and White accounted for all the runs, with Bill getting 2 key RBIs. The Birds win it, another thriller, and another one-run victory, and that, of course, is the mark of the champion.
And here are the totals now, as the Cardinals have moved to within only a game and a half of first place. And if they can win this second game, what we hope would have come about earlier, you know, is that we can only get within a game or two of the Dodgers going into the three-game series. Well, everything you gain before you play the Dodgers just emphasizes that you don't have to do the impossible or the miraculous. Now, if we could win this one here in the second game, all we need would be 2 out of 3 against the Dodgers to have a great chance to win the pennant. Here are the totals. 3 runs, 7 hits, no errors for the Cardinals. Rupert dead all the way. He has now won 9 and lost 11 for the season. I believe he's only pitched 3 complete games as a Cardinal. That's right. And 2 of them were against his old teammates, the Braves. So 3-7-0 for Burdette. A very important victory. His third win as a Cardinal against 6 defeats. Overall, he's now 9-11. And for the Braves, 2 runs, 6 hits, and 2 errors. Bob Hendley, the loser, he's now 9-9. Time of the ballgame, approximately 2 hours and 20 minutes. The Cardinals are now 9 in a row, 18 out of the last 19, only a game and a half out of first place, only 2 back on the lost side, and still rolling. Now, we'll be back with the second game in just about 15 minutes. This broadcast is brought to you by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, Brewers of Budweiser, Michelob, and Busch Bavaria, and by...